I don't trust my calculator. Sometimes it gives me the wrong answers. Now, my calculator will tell you that sometimes I punched the wrong numbers in the first place, but I don't buy it. So I've developed a strategy for just looking at the answer my calculator gives me and deciding whether or not it's right. And that, I'm going to show you that strategy right here. I'm going to show you how I figure out when my calculator's wrong. So we'll start off with some addition problems. What I do is I estimate. I'm adding 3.478 to 13.12. 3.478, that's around 3.5. 13.12 is around 13.1. So their sum should be around 16.6. Sure enough, that's what my calculator gave me. Probably right on that one. Next problem, we got a number that's around 145.7. I'm adding a number that's around 32.2. I should get a number that's around 177.9. Calculator probably got that one right too. Next one, I've got a number that's a little more than 6,200. I'm adding a number that's a little more than 300. I should get a number that's a little more than 6,500. That's not more than 6,500. This is the one that my calculator missed. Go ahead and check the last one just in case. Got a number that's a little more than 50. A number that's a little more than 1,300. I should get a sum that's a little more than 1,350. Sure enough, that's what I get. All right, on to some subtractions. All right, we're going to do the same thing. We'll do a little estimation. On my first one, I've got a number that's around 650. I'm subtracting a number around 50. I should get a number that's around 600. That one's okay. On to the next one, I've got a number that's around, let's see, that's around 3,440. And I'm subtracting a number that's around 2,130. I should get a difference that's around 1,310. That's not even close to 1,310. Yeah, my calculator whiffed on that one. Go ahead and check the other two, just in case. All right, on part C here, oh boy, I've got a number that's around 14,460. I'm subtracting a number that's around 260. I should get something around 14,200. It's pretty close to 14,200, so calculator got that one. On to my last one, I've got a number that's real close to 6.59. I'm subtracting something that's close to 0.03. I should get something that's about 6.56. B is the one my calculator missed. Let's try some multiplications. Now, my calculator's really bad at multiplication, so my calculator only got one of these right, missed the other three. So we're going to have to figure out which of these three are wrong and which one's right. So the first one, I'm multiplying a number that's a little bit less than 40 by a number that's a little bit less than 50. I should get a product that's a little bit less than 2,000. That's not a little bit less than 2,000, so yeah, calculator whiffed on that one. All right, on my next one, I've got a number that's a little more than 60. I'm multiplying a number that's a little more than 70. I should get a product that's a little more than 4,200. That one is a little more than 4,200, so I think my calculator probably got that one right. We'll take a look at the next one. I've got a number that's a little more than 310. I'm multiplying it by a number that's a little less than 1. Now, if I multiply this by a number that's less than 1, the result should be less than what I started with. I should get an answer that's less than 310. That's not less than 310. Calculator missed that one. Oh, what do I do here? Well, I'm going to think about powers of 10. Sometimes when I'm dealing with decimals, that's what I like to think about. Helps me, particularly when I'm multiplying them. We call this order of magnitude. I can write this 0.0031. I can write that as 3.1 times 10 to the negative third. And the 10 to the negative third, the power of 10 is what I really care about here. I can take any number and I can write it as a number between 1 and 10, that's 3.1, times some power of 10. We call this scientific notation. Because sometimes when you're working with problems, particularly when you're multiplying large numbers or really small numbers, what you really care about is the power of 10. I'm going to take that, and we'll see in just a moment why we care about this. This number is around 1.35 times 10 to the third. There are a bunch of other digits too, but we're just estimating here. It's 1.35 times 10 to the third. Now, when we multiply, of course, we can multiply the powers of 10, and we multiply the 10 to the third times the 10 to the minus third, we get 10 to the zero. That's just 1. So these cancel out. These will go away. And we have 3 times 1.35. 3 times 1.3 is 3.9. 3 times 1.4 is 4.2. This answer should be, you know, somewhere in that ballpark, around 4. That's not even close to 4. So the calculator missed this one as well. And we see that just thinking of the powers of 10 here helped us see that pretty quickly. Let's try some divisions. Well, calculator's really bad at multiplication. Division is just multiplying by the reciprocal. calculator's bad at division too. So let's see. We'll try the same thing. We'll think about powers of 10. For this first one, I've got a number that's around 3.4 times 10 to the third. And I'm going to divide by something that's around 3.1 times just 10 to the first. So my answer should be something around, you know, the 3.4 and 3.1, they're pretty close to each other. The 10 to the third divided by 10 to the first, that's going to be around 10 squared. It's going to be around 100. This answer's not even close to 100. So calculator missed this one. Now here on this one, I've got, well, 84 divided by 21, that's 4. But 0.084 is less than 0.21. So if I divide 0.084 by 0.21, I'm going to get something that's less than 1. 4, not less than 1. Calculator missed that one as well. On to the next one. Well, I've got a number that's around 8 divided by a number that's around 90. If I do 8 divided by 80, I'll get 1/10. I'll get 0.1. If I do 8 divided by 90, I should get something that's a little bit less than 0.1. That's a little bit less than 0.1, so I think the calculator has that one correct. Now here I've got a number that's around 350 divided by a number that's around 30. I'm going to get a number there that's kind of close to 10. It's going to be more than 10, but it's going to be close to 10. I'm certainly not going to get a number that's around 20. You know, if I'm going to divide something by 30 and get 20, it's going to be up around 600. 600 divided by 30, that's 20, not 354. So my calculator whiffed on that one too. So now you see I'm just using estimation here to check on my calculator because I don't trust it. And you know what? I probably need a new calculator. Ah, who are we kidding? I wouldn't trust that one either.